I think I'd miss this place. Had that much right.
At once. Yes?
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to be so rude. I'm Ista. I heard we have you to thank for clearing out the ogres. I'm glad Stalwart survived. It would have been a disappointing trip up here otherwise. My ore locating divination tool. Well, that's what it will be. I have to calibrate it. Right now it seems to think you're a copper deposit. Answer contacts did suggest that a particular strong soul essence might interfere. I'm more interested in minerals in any case. I suppose that's possible. It's not exactly what I'm looking for, unfortunately. Actually quite sophisticated, if you'll forgive me a little professional pride. A mix of alchemical processes and scrying enchantments, and some very expensive crystals. I'm trying to recreate the instruments that first led the Pargrin dwarves to this mountain. This is my latest prototype. Centuries ago, dwarves carrying tools just like this one followed their readings to what is now the battery. If I can recreate their work, then I may be able to find ore deposits elsewhere. I was hoping to test it, but my arrival was delayed by word of the ogre attack. I haven't been able to find anyone to venture up the mountain since. Oh, of course! A real field test is worth the investment. I just have to adjust the device. It should point you toward metal deposits. We already know the battery rests on some rich veins, but I was hoping to get a reading of the surrounding mountainside. If you can follow the readings to ore and bring back a sample, I can use it to refine the device. Thanks ever so much for this!
I'm here.
I hope you've had some luck, and do take care with that device. It has a few rather delicate components.
I'd be glad to.
Village was a touch livelier when I saw it last. Ain't saying much, though. A bitter cold and a persistent odor of fish. And that were just the people. Anything's better than Galvino's workshop. You ain't heard the old buzzard sing. Anyway, what about you? We seen lots coming through, trying to crack the battery, but no watchers. Ah, looking for someone. That's a familiar yarn. But don't let me keep you from the sights and sounds of Stalwart. They're easy to miss. Just 'cause I'm made of metal don't mean I got any special fondness for smiths and forges. Nothing specific. Everyone looks about the same when they got their fingers up their noses. Only the last group, one before you, there was something different about them. Couldn't put my finger on it, but they was dangerous. Almost felt the hair on the back of my neck. Ain't felt that way about anyone else walking through Galvino's door, that's for sure. No more than what Galvino already told you. For fancy dwarven poetry? None of them ever struck me as especially literate. So whichever you can stand to get close to. And that's on you. I lost my sense of smell 13 years ago. Murder, tracking, and the best materials for kindling. Those are more my area of expertise.
I'm here.
Back to warm your hand, Jay. What can I do for you? Nothing like a pint to take the chill off.
I'm here.
Back to warm your hand, Jay. What can I do for you?
You got the look of someone with his teeth around a secret.
My, but it's gotten warm in here.
You all right? I won't serve you if you're already drunk, you know.
Didn't think there was anything more in lice and hoarfrost to these folk, but you had a look back there. What do you find when you're rooting around like that? Mayhap I'm looking for someone. Woodcutter, by the name of Harmka. It sure does. He was one of them. The mob that destroyed Cold Morn. This man, Harmka, I saw him outside my house the night it burned, staring into the flames the way I seen you stare into souls. I knew it were a fool's errand trying to hunt down every man and woman that carried a torch into Cold Morn, but if I knew I got the one responsible for my kin and my hearth, I might could rest easy. I took a good long look that night. Ours was a little place with a yellow door, right on the edge of town. He was there. Besides, I asked around when I first got to Stalwart. Townsfolk said that all the woodcutters in town took part in the purge. Point of pride for them. I told you he was part of the mob. I spotted him watching my house when it burned. But when we find him, I want to know if he's the one responsible for my home, my parents, and my brothers and sister. I never thought I'd have the chance to know for sure, but you could look into his soul and find out, you being a watcher and all. Mighty fine of you. Mighty fine indeed. Don't know where he dallies these days, but someone in Stalwart could tell us. People from little villages, they always know. Thank you.
I'm here.
Back to warm your hand, Jay. What can I do for you? The woodcutter? Sure do. Head west from the village, then go north. If you see the frozen stream, you've gone too far. Usually works a stand of trees out in the russet wood, though he steps out from time to time.
Well, what are we waiting for?
Don't worry. We're not looking to murder him or anything.
And then you hit your own father?
Not I. That was Isselmir.
Yeah, but you're the same person.
Fying cock's feathers to that!
I see your point.
I'm here.
Certainly.
Something else you need? About the only thing folk here haven't tried. Killing one more matron won't change things for long.
But it could be fun.
Besides, her clan's flames that whisper. The one that attacked us was Wolf with many mouths. I'd know him anywhere.
They're cut from the same cloth, Uldric. Only a matter of time before Barragon marches through that gap in our walls.
It's a fool's hope. A fantasy that's kept these parts inhabited longer than they should be. They say the Pargrunan dwarves developed Durgan's steel, became powerful rich. And then one day, they locked their doors and died. Nothing like a mystery to stir folk up. Most of Stalwart is convinced that some Pargrun secret will save us all. But that don't stop them from whispering a prayer when they pass the old fortress. I'm a carpenter, mother's a builder, so it felt like a good fit at the time. Not that we've got a lot of new folk to build houses and furnishings for. These days, I spend most of my time fixing up the stockade. Mother's convinced that a magic forge will turn this frozen crack into a hub of civilization. She can't accept this place as dying. Me, I'd just as soon move on.
I'm here.
I take it you've met Galvino. Who? Sorry, I don't recall the name. Last expedition I met disappeared weeks ago. Didn't give any names, but they definitely haven't come back this way. Don't mean this Feyara weren't part of an expedition, though. We get groups passing by sometimes looking to try their luck. What's on your mind?
How much did the old snake pay you, Sina Hiod?
Maestro Galvino and I came to an agreement. It was for the good of Stalwart. I thought...
You thought you'd let a killer walk among us?
Enough! What's on your mind?
I'd be glad to.
Something else you need?
If doubts and curiosity plague you, you're skinning your knuckles on the wrong door. Huh. I suspect the answers will seed more questions. Aethys was the god of rebirth, and his light does not...
Yes? Watch yourself on the mountain. In these lean times, everything looks like prey to something.
They gone? Have those nasty brutes finally left? I heard the ogres outside, tearing down walls and murdering folk. Don't remember how things got this bad. But you're the new adventurer, Renengild's latest volunteer. A real spitfire, she told me. Bet you'd whip those layabouts at the mine into shape. Did you say something, dear? Me? I was the overseer at the mine, back when it was running. Got shut down decades ago when we couldn't sell or ship the stuff. But I still remember plenty about the mining business, and I got as many folk as I can digging out the entrance. Been praying to the salty wench that I don't forget too much afore they finish the job. Got to speak up? My hearing ain't what it was.
I'm here.
Got to speak up? My hearing ain't what it was.
Thank you.
Sinove, please. If we go now, we can get behind the barricade. We won't do any good here.
We're gonna go down fighting. Anyone who feels differently can settle it with me right now.
Absolutely.
So, you're back. What can I do for you? Not so brave now, are you? What? Did I spill something on myself?
Hello, sir. Anything I can do for you?
You find anything? Hate to think of those slimy bastards carrying my haul into a freezing hole somewhere.
That's the last of them. Check the rest of the supplies while I load these.
You sure about the route? Not much choice. Snows have covered most of the other passes. This one gets just enough traffic to stay open. You find anything? Hate to think of those slimy bastards carrying my haul into a freezing hole somewhere.
Is she there? Did you find Avala?
I'm here. I'm here.
Got to speak up? My hearing ain't what it was. That name, it carries memories of death, war, fury, the taste of blood. What do you want with it? What trickery is this, stranger? You think a Pargrin would so easily betray her own people? Arms Warden Maroon will see you cast into the White Forge. Hammers of Durgan, ring loud. May the anvil's deep music resound. Walls of the battery, safeguard our works from marauder and wilder alike. Abidun's faithful, travail by the forge and the fires that brighten the ore.
At once.
Got to speak up? My hearing ain't what it was.
I'm here.
Got to speak up? My hearing ain't what it was. That name. It carries memories of death, war, fury, the taste of blood. What do you want with it? What trickery is this, stranger? You think a Pargrin would so easily betray her own people? Forgive me. I didn't recognize you. Then you're not one of Zoltan's visiting merchants or Exandru's foreign zealots. You're one of us. Then let us share the words of our bond, brother. Did I nod off? My, but I had the strangest dream. So much work to be done. Pardon me, but I'd better check on those miners. At the rate they're going, it'll be another year before they clear that blazing shaft. Let's hear it then. Plenty of work to be done indeed.
Old leaf brandy? Isn't that a tad expensive for a mercenary's wages?
It is if you pay in silver. I paid in steel.
That's the most senseless act of...
I traded a very nice dagger for it. What kind of bloodthirsty lunatic do you think I am?
One with exquisite taste.
I'd be glad to. I'm here. Thank you. Certainly.
Good thing I'm freshly greased.